Hello. Welcome to Lucy's Big Beautiful World of Painting. My name is Lucy Aita. I'm a Wilson Bickford trained instructor, and I teach the methods of Wilson Bickford along with some of my own. Today, I'm going to be doing my own original painting of a rock formation, a little waterfall, and some pretty trees with some nice bright colors in them. What I've done so far to save a little time was I painted on a little pattern with acrylic paint. This is not a detailed picture. I just left a spot here opened for some water to lay flat and the waterfall. Here is the acrylic paint. All of the black is the acrylic paint. It is the only time I'll be using acrylic paint. The rest of the painting will be done in oil, and I'm using an 11 by 14 wrapped canvas today. So this wrapped canvas, you can just hang up right on the wall, let it dry for a couple weeks right on the wall, okay? So this is a little different than using a flat panel. So with that being said, I'm going to get started painting. Here we go. So also, I put some liquid white to make my sky flow a little easier. Here we go. I'm going to be using some ultramarine blue on a 1-inch scenery brush. And I have some paints out from before, so you see some was mixed with a little white from before. Just taking some very dark ultramarine, tapping it into the brush. Again, this is a 1-inch scenery brush. Here we go. I'm going to start rubbing in a nice sky. And it's a little bit of a smaller canvas than I was using on the other shows, so I can take my time a little more. And here we go. I'm going to leave some white pockets, kind of make it look like a little bit of clouds peeking through. And as I come down closer to the horizon, I'm just going to turn the brush over and let some of that paint just kind of get lighter. I'm not adding any more paint to the sky. I think that's going to be dark enough. I'm going to be putting trees across the horizon line, just as long as we get a little bit of the blue in there. And I will blend that in a minute. While I have blue on this 1-inch brush, I'm just going to come down, and this is our waterfall here. Just going to rub a little blue in there, make it a little easier so when I go over with the white, I'll already have some shadows in there. There we go. So, I'm going to take a feather brush. This is a 2-inch feather brush, a fine hair brush. Smooth out my sky. Now, some of the blue will go over into those white spots, and that's okay. Just want to get a little bit of a cloud formation look. It's all an illusion. It's a flat surface. We wanted to try to make it look three-dimensional just by adding some color and some strokes. Okay, so this would be considered a simple sky today. And I smoothed it out a little. Now, I'm going to take a clean scenery brush, another 1-inch brush, going into some yellow ochre. Again, tapping it, just tapping in some paint. I don't want to use too much paint. Going to scrub in some trees going across the back. I want to add some nice bright colors today, some fall colors, and this yellow ochre is a great fall color. There we go. On the corner of the brush, just going to go up and down. I'm not worried if I go into this black, so we're going to be covering that too. Just want to get an illusion of some bushes. I'm going to turn my brush over, going right over, going up and down, just whatever I see in my mind. There we have some trees in the back. Now, we don't want them to be a blank color, so I'm going to come into my sap green, not even washing out my brush. We try not to use thinner, as little as we can, because it will thin our paint too much and will make a mucky mess. So we want the colors to be vivid. There is times when we do use our thinner to thin paint down on a script liner, which I'll show you later. Okay, so I'm just going to come in various areas, put a little bit of green. Even in fall, there's still some green that shows. We still have green left here and there. So you can see I'm just gently turning the brush in circles. I'm going to turn it over, get some of the green off the other side of the brush. There we go. Got a little bit of green. Pretty color. Alrighty. Now what I'd like to do is a little trick. I have a palette knife. With this palette knife, I'm going to scrape up into the paint and put in illusion of branches. And you can hear it scraping. I'm not going through the canvas, I'm just scraping lightly. And these will be some branches. Just a little extra detail to show in the background. And scrape some taller, some bigger. There we go. Okay, so I'll put a few more in the middle. Here we go, some nice branches. Now, even with this green on my brush, most of it came off. There's not too much left. So I think I'm going to go into a little bit of this it's called cadmium orange. And with the green in there, it should turn it a little bit brown. I'm sorry, this is cadmium red, but it is more orange. That's what I meant to say. So here we go. You can see how the red is mixing. And now we have kind of a autumn color. And I'll just gently go back and tap my brush. And by tapping the brush, it's giving it a little more detail. I'm going over some of my branches, and that's going to show my limbs and branches, and it's going to make them look like they are in the background more. There we go. So just randomly dabbing. Rather than scrubbing, when I dab, you can see here that there's a little bit more detail. It almost gives the illusion of it being some leaves. So I don't want to get rid of all of my limbs and all, so I'm just dabbing here and there. And now we got some nice fall color starting to show. Okay, there we go. Starting to look like fall already. I'll place this brush down and I'm going to take my palette knife again, but this time I'm going to lay some rocks into this waterfall. So I have some paint spread out. This is black and Van Dyke brown. I think I'll just add a little more. I want it to be a little more brown since that background is black. We want this to show up. And I think I'll just put a little bit of yellow ochre in there just to lighten it a little so it might be a little easier for you to see. There we go. So I'm taking my palette knife and I'm scraping up a pretty large amount of paint on there. And here's how I'm going to come in from the right. Doesn't matter right or left. I'm just starting at the right. And going to scrape on just a rock formation. No rhyme or reason to this. It's going to break up the black. And once it breaks up that black, you'll be surprised how it just starts to look like rocks. And I'm pushing and scraping the paint on. I can even take some off like that, move it around. We want this to look like a cliff almost. Yeah, look at that. Some of that yellow ochre came out. Lightened that up a little bit. So I'm going to have some rocks in here. And we'll put some grasses on the bottom. There we go. I'm going to come in again. See, I'm just holding my knife sideways, pushing it down, scraping that paint right off that knife. And I'm glad I have a little of that yellow ochre in there. I'm going to come back and highlight it also. And once you highlight it, then you'll see how we'll see how the rocks really stick out. And I can always come back and add more. There we go. Some simple rocks. Yeah, what I'd like to do is I'm going to take a little bit of raw sienna. I'm just going to mix it in with my brown. Whatever is left, I may have to make a little more. And that's okay. And it's okay that I'm not mixing it thoroughly. You can see it has a little bit of a marble effect to it, and that's good. Make it look a little more natural. For a quick painting, It's hard to make things look natural, but as close as we get, as appealing it is to look at, that's what counts. So I don't see that too much, so I will come back, put a little more. Actually, that's a lot more. And really lighten that up. Now I'll take some and I'm just going to come in various parts where my rocks are and lay some of this lighter color on. I don't want to cover all of the darks, just putting it here and there. And then I'll do one step further and I will come in with some yellow ochre and lighten it even more. Yeah, I'm using all I have left here, and that's a nice light color, the yellow ochre. Like a golden brown color, almost like a mustard color. And I will come up here, and I'm actually letting the paint stick to the paint that's underneath. And we'll get some highlights on those rocks. That's what's going to make those rocks stick out. I'm just scraping my knife on. I have a big pile of paint under there this time. And I have a little ball of paint there, and I could just wipe that off. These knives are great because they bend. This happens to be a Wilson Bickford knife from his set, and they bend without breaking, so you can bend it any way that you need to. There we go. Have a little bit of rock formation in there now, and I can come back and make adjustments to that in a little while. So I'm going to go on to the next step. I will wipe my knife off and set that aside right now. Okay, so I'm going to work on the waterfall a little bit. For the waterfall, I'm taking a fan brush. I already put a little bit of blue in here, so now we want to add some whites to it. So I'm going to load my fan brush with quite a bit of white. There we go. That might be a little too much. So I can just move it down on my palette, get a little of that paint off there. There we go, I think that might be it. Now for my waterfall, I'm just gonna come in the way the water is flowing down. And I'll come back and get more white. And I'm using that corner of the brush just to give it that angle. And that's okay if I go over that white, the black a little bit. Just wanna get some waterfall effect in there. And I will come down here and just fill in a little. Now, if I get rid of a little bit too much of that blue, that's okay. I'll come back and put some more in. There we go. So I can see you may or may not show too much on camera. So I think what I'll do is I'll just put my brush in this little bit of blue. Just come in and gently, using the tip of the brush, putting a little more blue in just so you can see it better. I can scrub a little of this down here. Oh, got a little brown to make it look like a little bit of water flowing. But we may end up covering that with some grasses, so I'm not going to worry about that for now. Okay, now I'm going to put in some front grasses using my scenery brush again. I'm going to go back into this green just as we started up top with the green and the yellow ochre. And I'll put the darker color down first. And I'm just going to tap some green in. And this brush is great. It has a little edge that I can kind of squeeze it in there between the easel, and that helps a bit. There we go. So I'm kind of making this painting up as I'm going along, just for the lesson, so you can see how easy it is. When you start painting, you just add whatever colors you like, whatever elements you like, you mix up your brushes. There we go. So I have some green in, and I think I'll come in between here, put a little grasses in between. I'm going on where I have some of that portion of the black, that's the plain acrylic underneath, just to fill that in a little. And I'm just coming back to my palette, reloading more paint, putting a little green. We're going to put some highlights on there just to fill in my canvas a little, even on the side of the water. So what I'm doing is I'm just going in between where I see a lot of black and patting in. I'm just pushing the brush in and putting that green on. Okay, we'll go one step further, and I can even use this color here. I'm just loading up my brush, And we can come back following the way the land might go and just press more on top of that green. We'll leave some of that green showing. This will help give depth to the painting. I'll come back and get more. See, I haven't even cleaned the brush. Have this be like a little mound. We'll have our tree come out of. There we go. Put a little highlights here and there on top of the grasses. Give a little more depth. Everything we add to the painting will give more depth to it. Depth and detail. In a half an hour, it's hard to get a lot of detail, but using these brushes and these methods, you can get more detail than you could imagine. There we go. Okay, a little more highlights in there. Now, what I would like to do is come in and put in some big trees. And for that, I'm using a different brush. This is a flat brush. And I've used these flat brushes mostly all of my paintings. And you can see, they call it a flat brush because it's flat. And I just want to dip in my thinner because it seemed very dry. So I dipped in a odorless terpenoid, which is a thinner that we clean our brushes with. We also use it for dampening our brushes and using a script liner, which I'm going to use in a few minutes. So I'd like to put in some big trees. By putting in the big trees, everything will look behind the big trees. We want things to look in the background, some elements to look in the background, some to look in the foreground. So I'm going to use a mixture of brown, which is Van Dyke brown, and black. I want a very dark color. There we go. And the paint seems a little thick, so this is when we would use our thinner. I'm just dipping in my thinner just a little, and you can see that loosens the paint right up. It got smoother. This is like a whipped butter now. Now, what I will do is to add my trees, I will hold up my brush on the chisel edge, starting from the top, and I'm going to push the brush down. Then as I get further down, I'm going to widen it up. So the tree bottom is wider. It doesn't have to be that straight. It just so happens my tree came out pretty straight, but you know, trees are all, in nature, trees are all different angles, okay? So, for the sake of teaching, that's okay if it came out straight, but it does not have to be. I'm mixing up some more paint here. I put a little more thinner. If I didn't put the thinner, I would pick up a lot of paint from underneath. This thinner is helping my brush slide over the paint a little without picking too much up underneath. All right, here we go. Gonna add some bigger trees on this side. So I'm going to start a little heavier on top, and I'm purposely making it a little crooked this time. There we go. Now we have another tree there. I'm just simply wiping my brush on a paper towel and going back into my paint again. There we go. We want it nice and dark, brown and black. Now, this tree I will put on the side, coming in a little, same thing. I'm going to make this one bigger also and a little crooked. Don't want to have all straight trees. And I put three trees. For composition, it's always better to have an uneven amount. I'll even bring this down a little. And look, I got some nice yellow ochre in there. Make that look like some highlights. I like that when it looks like the highlights. Like it was all done for me. Okay, going to wipe this off. I'd like to add some highlights on the tree trunks themselves. Now, I don't have a light source in this painting, so I'm just gonna take my knife, just for the sake of the lesson, I'd like to show you how to add the tree trunks. Let's see what color we can use. I think I'm gonna take some of this mixture that I already used. So we have a nice color harmony. I don't want to mix too many colors up. And I just added some white. There we go. And a marble effect. Same thing. I'm pulling out. I'm going to wipe this off so you can see it better. I want to wipe off my knife. I'm just wiping it off a little. Here we go. You can see that bead of paint. So what I'd like to do is come in and just add a little bit of a definition to the tree, add a little highlight just here and there. Like I said, we don't really have a light source, so wherever I put it, this will make the tree stick out and separate from the rocks in the background. You can see I'm just dabbing and pulling some paint over. Just have to hold the knife on an angle. Come over and I will put a little more in here, and that'll separate it from that background. And slide it up, pull the paint over. That one has a little more on it, and that's okay. I want to separate that there. Okay? Yeah, do a little more over here. I want to make sure it's separated from the background. There we go. And it's okay, those colors are blended now. I made that a little bigger. I need to turn my arm and come in from the other direction a little, because my easel bottom is in the way. So I can just pull that over. There we go. Now to pull that paint over, I can take a fan brush, and at the end of it, I can just pull this paint over very gently in one direction, and it will give those trees a little bit of a roundness to them. I'm just going on the end. I'm not going all the way to where I started with the knife. I'm just going to the end and pulling them around. Here we go, coming along. What I'd like to do now is add some branches. Now, when I add the branches, I'm using a brush that is a long script liner, and I just put it in the thinner so you can see it's starting to drip a little. And this is a long script liner. There's a short one, and this is a long one. In order to do the branches on this brush, the paint has to be thin. So I have to dip in the thinner and make it like a milky or an inkiness to it. There we go. Now, using the tip of the brush, I will just start to wiggle in some tree branches. Okay. Now, for the sake of time, I won't be able to put in too many, because I'd like to show you a new brush today called the Funny Brush. Yes, it's really called the Funny Brush. So I'd like to show you that and get some more fall colors in here. So I'm going to put in just a few branches, and you can see I'm overlapping. I'm pulling them out from the tree. I'm moving my hand back and forth and wiggling them around, making some thicker and some thinner. And a little practice with this brush, and it's very easy. You do have to practice. I might be making it look a little easier than it actually is. I've been doing this for a few years. But once you practice a little, it's a lot of fun to use this brush. Okay, so there we go. We have some nice limbs coming off of our trees. Now I'd like to get out the funny brush. This is a funny brush. And really what it is, it's a bunch of like rubber bands that are all together. And you can get a nice look of tree leaves with this. So I'm dipping it into my thinner, and I'm coming right over into my red color. And this is like a pinky red. And you can see I'm like thinning it out. Now, I don't want it to look pink, so I think I'm just going to dab in a little brown. There we go. You can see I'm just swooshing it around, and it might drip a little because I have to use quite a bit of medium. Now, to use this brush, all you do is dab. Now, when it starts to pick up the paint, it's time to get more paint. So it's a little tricky because you have to get the right amount of paint on here not to pick up the paint that's underneath. And you have to keep going back. You can just dab a couple times, and then you have to go back and pick up more paint. But this is such a fun brush to use because you can use it on any scenes that you're doing that you want to put leaves. And you can change the colors on it and all kinds of colors. And it just looks like leaves without dabbing them separately. So with this wet on wet method, this is a great brush to use. It also can be used with other paint mediums like acrylics if you want to. Now we're starting to look like fall because we have some nice red in there. Let's see. There we go. Looking a little bit more like fall now. I'm just going to rub this funny brush on a paper towel, dip back in my thinner, just kind of wipe off some of that color because I would like to go to a yellow. Now, I have some of that color still in there, and that's okay. Remember, we're looking for fall colors. So, I'm just mixing it into my yellow, and now I will go back and put on another color. Wow, look at that. Now we really have some nice fall colors. So, when you have darks and lights and you go next to each other, that's what really makes them pop out. Oops, almost went in the wrong pile there. There we go. Getting a little more fall. Now, since it's fall, let's put some down here. Maybe some of them are falling off the tree. We can just put some. Maybe they fell off a little. Oh, I got some paint on my easel. So the leaves are falling off even on my easel. There we go. Okay. I think we have enough of this color. Now, what I'd like to do, well, isn't that funny? I said, I think we have enough, and I still went back and put a little more. That's the fun part of this. This is so much fun, you want to keep adding the leaves on. All right, I'm going to squish this around a little bit. I should say swish it. You can hear that I'm rubbing it on the screen in the cleaning bucket, and I got a lot of that paint off this time. Okay, because now I want to go into the yellow, and I don't want any of those other colors. Oh, I got a little, but that's okay. I'm going to go right into the yellow. I want to make a real light color, a yellowish color. Oops, got a little drip there. Here we go. Just for a little highlight now. And let's see how that looks. Just get a little. I don't want to put too much of this. We don't really have a sun source. Just want it to really stick out. Come on the bottom. There's those leaves that fell off those trees again. I'll put some here and there. Looks like they fell right off there. Okay. Last, what I would like to do is I'd like to just come in and fix up my waterfall a little bit on top here, just to even this out a little, make it look like it's falling over. And like I said, could always come in and scrub a little. Okay, and got a little brown in there, but that's okay. We'll just move that right in. That's the beauty of oil paint. You can move it right around. Last, come in with a little green, tap out the little bottom of these trees so it doesn't look like they're kind of floating on top of anything. And I think that that might be it for our little fall scene today. Lots of changes I could make and lots more I can do, but for this amount of time, I think that this is a pretty good example of how you can use acrylic painting and acrylic underpainting on part of your painting, and then add the oil on top of it. So you learned a lot of detailed work today in a quick amount of time, and I hope that you've enjoyed the show today, and I hope that you'll tune in again another time. Thank you.